which is on comparison of efficient of using HTML over XML and JSON for the asynchronous communication in rich internet applications. So that paper will be presented by Nalakaruwan Dissanayake, who is assistant lecturer in software engineering in Informatics Institute of Technology, Colombo. He is reading for his MPhil program at the University of Colombo School of Computing. He has received his BSc in software from Sri Lanka Institute of Information Technology. So he is keen interest in research area such as software architectures, rapid application development, and internet applications. So let me hand over to Ruan to do his presentation.
Dear Chair and everyone else, good evening. I'm Nalaka. My research is a comparison of the efficiency of using HTML over XML and JSON for the asynchronous communication in rich internet applications. So I will give a brief introduction to the domain and specify the methodology and discuss the results and some findings, and we'll conclude and finally specify some future work we have identified. So when we consider computer applications, everybody knows that we can divide them into desktop applications and web-based applications. Then talking about web-based applications, again we can divide into traditional web applications and rich internet applications in this era of Web 2. And with the development approaches of the rich internet application, we can divide into a proprietary plugin-based approach and the script-based approach. Actually, this plugin-based approach is dying at the moment. And the more famous approach is this script-based approach using techniques like Ajax or WebSockets. That's our targeted domain. Then talking about these rich internet applications, they have this partial page rendering features, capabilities, and they have rich GUIs, graphical user interfaces, and they're highly interactive and fast. Almost all the web applications you are experiencing these days are rich internet applications. So this asynchronous communication can be seen as a key feature of this rich internet application, especially providing the rich features. If you take a look into the abstract algorithm of this asynchronous communication, first the client sends the request to the server as a normal HTTP request, but it's called the XML HTTP request. Then server receives and processes the request, maybe read some data from a file or database. Then server serializes the data, which means server formats the data and prepare for the communication using a specific technique. Then server sends the response to the client and client receives the response. Then the client deserializes the data, which means he reads data back from that serialized data set and prepare it again to be displayed on the UI. Then client renders the results on the UI by partially rendering the UI instead of reloading the page. So this serialization and deserialization phases are highlighted in our project. For serialization of data, there are two main techniques. The early one is the XML. It uses nested elements and attributes to specify the structure of the message. And the later one is JSON. It's text-based and lightweighted. JSON is already proven to be better than XML. So our research objective is to check the use of HTML in asynchronous communication by the terms of the efficiency of time taken for the asynchronous communication process and the size of the data communicated. So for this research, we developed a small tool to experiment. There you can see there are two inputs, the number of iterations and the number of entries. Then we have three buttons for HTML, XML, and JSON. So when we specify, when we enter the number of iterations and entries and click on a button, the request goes to the server, and that the entered number of entries will be read from a database and serialize the data and send it back to the client. Then client deserialize and prepare a table like this and display the table on the UI, not only the table, but the start time, end time, and the total duration of all serialization, deserialization, and the complete process. And this will be iterated multiple number of times, specified in this number of iteration the input, and calculates the average for accurate results. For the views or the web page, we used HTML5 and CSS3. The client side was developed using JavaScript and jQuery. For the server side, PHP was used, and we used Apache web server and MySQL DBMS server, and we used AJAX for the asynchronous communication. And we conducted this experiment for three different environments. First one is localhost using the SAM tool, and second one using a remote server accessed via proxy firewall, and third one using a remote server accessed directly. And we conducted the experiments for 10, 20, 50, and 100 number of entries to be read from the database. And we set the number of iterations to 10. Talking about the results, for the time efficiency, for all serialization, deserialization, and complete request time of localhost and the remote server accessed via proxy server are similar. The pattern looks like this. So you can see JSON has the lowest time and the XML is the highest. HTML is somewhere in between. When the remote server is accessed directly also, for the serialization and deserialization, the pattern was similar. But for the complete request time, there were some anomalies. So we tried to identify the pattern, but there wasn't any that identifiable pattern here, right? So basically, it's in some cases JSON is better, in some cases XML is better, in some cases HTML is better. But if you take a closer look into the data set, you will see that the difference between these techniques are really small. It's limited to a couple of tens of milliseconds, right? So we think it's neglectable, so we can ignore that kind of small difference. Talking about the size efficiency, in all the cases, the pattern looks like this, right? JSON has the lower size, then the XML. HTML, of course, has the highest size. But you can see in the first two lines, which means for 10 entries and 20 entries, it's kind of OK. But when the number of entries go high, for an example, the yellow one, the 100 entries, the size of the HTML data set was almost double the XML and JSON. But the actual scenario of the synchronous communication in rich internet application, we don't go for this 50 entries and 100 entries. Most of the time, if you have to display a larger set of data on the UI, the pagination pattern is used. So the data set is divided into multiple data pages, and a single page is displayed at a time. So most of the time, per single data page, 10 to 20 entries will be used. So for one communication cycle per data page, a smaller data set will be communicated. So because of that reason, for the results, we considered only 10 and 20 entries cases. Talking about the results, for the time efficiency, HTML performs better than XML, and HTML performs lower than JSON, but it's really closer to JSON. Right, far better than XML, lower than JSON, but closer to JSON. For the size efficiency, HTML performs lower than both XML and JSON. So however, that performance is less than 100 bytes. It's a small number. So we noted some advantages of using HTML. When we are using HTML, even though we say there is a deserialization phase, there is no actual data passing. So it's just displaying the received HTML data set on the UI. So the workload in the client side is really reduced. And because of that reason, when there are any changes, change in the server side code is enough. So it decreases the coupling between client and the server code. And because of both these facts, it enhances the modifiability, and additionally it increases the reusability, because that the same code we use to request data can be used to display the data on the initial page load. So anyway, we noted down some facts to consider when you are selecting the technique. For time critical systems, go for JSON, not HTML. But anyway, we have to consider a better asynchronous communication technique like WebSocket before considering JSON over HTML, because it means a lot. Because if you are familiar with these asynchronous communication techniques, you know that the Ajax needs more resources than WebSockets. So you have to consider the asynchronous communication technique first. And for scalability, again, of course, use JSON. But if there are enough resources compared to the amount of communication, right? If you have the lightweighted client base and the amount of communication is low, you can always consider HTML because it helps modifiability. Okay? If you want modifiability in your system, always go for HTML. But you have to consider if time and size efficiencies are not critical, right? So I conclude my research as follows. So HTML can be recommended for asynchronous communication in rich internet applications. I highlight again when time and size efficiencies are not critical. And however, HTML is better than XML in the terms of time and modifiability and the ease of development. So we have identified some future work to be done. This is still a part of ongoing research. So when HTML is used, as I told you earlier, there is no deserialization in the client. So using that advantage, so we have noted, we can derive some patterns for CRUD operations, for create, read, update, and delete operations in client side of the asynchronous communication process. So that using that patterns, we think we can design some abstract algorithms for CRUD operations, especially for forms and grid-based features of the rich internet applications. So based on these algorithms, we hope to develop JavaScript library to support client-side development of the asynchronous communications in rich internet applications. So thank you. And questions at that time, not only the questions, since this is an ongoing research, the feedback are really welcome. Thank you.